In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Binance trading bot such that you can set up the bot with your own trading strategy and it will automatically trade for you 24/7. Binance trading bot uses grid trading strategy where you create something like a price box within which your trading will occur. A grid is like a box where you have a lower price point and an upper price point. And you tell the bot that it should only trade as long as the price of the coin you are trading is within this price range that you have specified. For example, let's say you want to trade Ethereum. You can go to a site like CoinGecko.com and look at the Ethereum chart for like the past 7 days. You will see that in this time frame, the price of Ethereum has been between $3,100, which is the lower price point, and about $3,350, which is the upper price point. So anywhere inside this price range box here, between these two prices is your grid where your trading can occur. Once you set up your trading bot, it will automatically buy some Ethereum for you anytime it sees the price around the low range and automatically sell some Ethereum for you anytime it sees the price around the high range here. That is how grid trading works. Because the bot will always buy low and sell high, you will end up making a profit as long as the price of the coin you are trading stays within the range that you have specified. If the price goes out of the grid, that is, if the price falls lower than your lower price limit, or if the price rises higher than your upper price limit, your bot will stop trading. When the price returns to that price range you have specified, the bot will continue trading again. That's if you don't close it. Apart from the upper and lower price limits, you can also specify the number of grids that you want the bot to create. The number of grids means the number of times the bot should buy and sell as long as the price goes up and down. For example, if you choose 2 grids, the bot will buy once and sell once every time the price goes up and down this price range. Now that you understand how grid trading bots work, I will show you how to set it up on the Binance platform. As a side note, the trading bot is not available for spot trading for now, so keep that in mind. If you want to use the Binance trading bot, you can only do so if you are trading futures. If you prefer to do spot trading with the trading bot, which is what I recommend for beginners, I have another video showing you a platform you can use to do that. It's really easy to use, and in my video on it, I showed you step by step how to do so. You can click on the link somewhere on your screen to watch that video. So back to the Binance trading bot. When you log into your Binance account, click on derivatives and select USD futures. Click on start trading. By default, you will see the coin being traded as BTC USDT. If you want to trade something else, just hover your mouse on this BTC USDT and click on this search bar here to search for any other coin you want to trade. In this case, let's say I want to trade Ethereum and I want to trade it with the USDT pair. So I'll make sure that I click Ethereum USDT. Not the quarterly one, the perpetual one, this one. If you can't see the space for grid trading on the right here, just hover your mouse on this settings bar here and come to multiple charts. You will see grid trading listed here. So click on it and it will open up the grid trading page. So the first thing you need to do is pick a trading position. Are you neutral? That is, we don't really know if it's going to be long or short. Or do you want the bot to be biased towards long? Or do you want it to be biased towards short? What that just means is you select short if you think that prices are going to fall. You select long if you think that prices are going to go up. You select neutral if you are not sure which way is going to go. Then always remember your leverage. By default, it will be 20x. 20x means that you're trading with 20 times whatever your amount of money is, but you can click on it and select any other leverage position that you want to use. As a beginner, I will always suggest
go to 1x, which means you are only trading with your money. So if you change this, you can click on confirm and your leverage will be 1x. But it's up to you. If you want to trade with leverage, you can always come back here, click on it and select any other leverage that you want. The next thing you need to do is choose the mode of the grid. You have two options, arithmetic or geometric. Arithmetic means that each grid is going to have an equal price difference. So for example, the bot will buy you more Ethereum every time the price drops by $100, for example. So that's what it means. There will be an equal price difference between each of the grids. For geometric, it means that each grid has an equal price ratio difference. So that's the difference between the two. But I'm going to go with arithmetic. Next, enter the lower price range for the coin you want to trade. If I go to CoinMarketCap and look at the price of Ethereum for the past 7 days, I will see that it has had a low price of 3,100 and a high price of just above 3,800. So I can choose to tell my bot to have a low price of 3,300 and a high price of 3,850, for example. In that case, I will come here and enter 3,300. And for the upper price, I will enter 3,850. Next, I need to specify the number of grids that I want the bot to use. I can specify any number between 2 and 149. If I choose 2 grids, it means the bot will buy once and sell once. If I choose 3 grids, it means the bot can decide to buy 2 times and sell once. Just like that. So you need to select the number of grids that you want to have. So any number you put here, for example, let me say 10, it will tell you the average amount of profits that you will get every time that grid runs. So for this range that I have now, if I'm using 10 grids, it means that I'm going to be making 1.39% to 1.63% every time the bot does a trade. But if I reduce it to 5 grids, you can see that I'll be making more profits. The reason I'm making more profits when I have fewer grids is because the bot is buying and selling less. So let me say price moves from 100 to 200, for example, and my bot trades 10 times. It means that it's going to buy and sell for shorter price movements. But if my bot trades only 3 times, it means that it will buy and sell for a bigger price difference. That's why less number of grids gives you more profits. But let's say I want to go with 6 grids because I like even numbers. The next thing I need to do is specify how much money I want the bot to trade with. Right here, it will tell you the minimum amount of money that you need to be able to run this bot with these settings that I've provided. And it's telling me that I need at least 26.35 USDT. I don't have any money in my futures account right now, but if I had some money, I'll be able to specify how much USDT I want the bot to trade with here. So once I've done that, I can click on create. There are some advanced options here that you can use to control the behavior of the bot. Because for example, once you create a bot, the bot is going to buy your initial amount of that coin you want to trade at whatever the current price is. So right now I'm saying I want to trade between 3,400 and 3,800. Let's assume the price is 3,800 now. If I just create the bot will buy my first initial quantity of Ethereum at 3,800. But I might not want that. I might want the bot to wait a little, let the price of Ethereum drop before it buys the first order. So I will put a trigger price here. The trigger price is the price at which the bot is going to start. So if I come here and I put 3,650, for example, what that means is the bot is not going to start until Ethereum price drops to 3,650. Then at that price, it will buy my initial quantity and then it will start trading as it pleases. Next is the stop trigger. So this is for me to put the price I want it to stop loss for both the bottom and the top price. And then I can tell the bot that when I stop the bot, it should either cancel all my orders or close all my positions. It's important to understand the difference. If you choose cancel all orders on stop, what it means that any orders that have not been filled at the time you stop the bot, those ones will be cancelled. If you don't select it, then you can go and manually cancel your orders later. But it's a good idea to always select this one so that you can just cancel any other orders that have not been filled. This other option says close all positions on stop. What it means is that it's going to close all your positions. That means sell your coins at whatever the current market price is. It's not a good idea if you are in loss, except you just want to stop loss at that point. So these are extra options that you can set, but of course they are optional, so you don't have to set them if you don't want to. But once you are finished putting in your parameters, click on create and you will see the details of the bot around here. Once that happens, the bot will keep running and it will keep buying and selling for you as the price of the coin goes up and down.
That is how to use the Binance trading bot. If you don't have a Binance account yet and you want to create one, you can use my referral link in the description box below and you will get 10% off your trading fees every time you trade. You can also check out the description box of this video for links to my crypto trading courses, my crypto trading book, as well as my referral links and codes. Thank you for watching and God bless your hustle.